Hello everyone, today we are going to learn about how to add, subtract the number 10 and 0. Now this is a very interesting topic in itself. The reason being that once you understand how to add these numbers, you can do it mentally and very quickly. So first, let us understand and focus on how to add the number 0. If I have, say for example, 7 balls in my bag and nobody gives me anything, so that means I'm going to add the number 0 to it, I will always get the same number itself because no balls got added in my bag, so I only have 7 balls at the end remaining. Similarly, I can take any number and if I add the number 0 to it, I will always get the same number because nothing is getting added to the first number. So the final answer will also be the same. I'll take another example. Like if I take the number 12 and if I add a 0 to it, it will still remain 12. So this is the way I go ahead and understand the concept of adding a 0 to a number. It will always give me the same number. On the same lines, let us see if what happens when we subtract the number 0. For example, if I have 7, let's take another color over here. If I have 7 flowers in my basket and I don't give anything to anyone, I keep the 7 flowers intact in my basket, that means I am not subtracting anything, I'm subtracting a 0. So I will get the same answer. Let's take another example. If I take the number 13 and I subtract a 0 from it, means I'm not taking away anything from 13 and I will get the answer as 13. Lastly, let us take an example of the number 20. If I'm subtracting again a 0 from it, I will get the same number. Why is that happening? Because I'm not removing anything from the first number. So the end result will be the same number. So I can conclude that whenever I add the number 0 or subtract the number 0, my answer will remain the same as my first number. Further, let us now see what happens if I add and subtract the number 10. Now, in my previous classes, I very well know that if I have a number, it always has a place value along with it. So number 6 belongs to my ones, and now I do not have any number under my tens. So if I add a number 10 over here, what would happen? Not my ones number would not change at all because there is a 0 in the ones over here. So only there will be 1 added to this tens column. So the number would change to a 16. Now further, if I had to subtract a number 10 from another number. So for example, I have the number 24, in which I have 2 tens and 4 ones. And if I'm subtracting a 10 out of it, I would get a 14. What would happen again over here? That there will be no change in the number in the ones column, but only 1 10 would be taken away from here. And the end result would be a 14. So this is the way we understand how do we add the number or subtract the number 10. Further, let us see some examples in terms of a word problem where we are going to do the same operation. So I would be showing you a very good example over here. You had $2 and though you were very hungry, you did not buy any snacks. how much money did you still have? So, to be very precise over here, I know that I had $2 in my pocket. And I was very hungry, but I didn't want to spend any money. So I did not buy any snacks. That means no money came out of my pocket. That means it was a zero which got subtracted. And then at the end, how much money will I have left? It would be, again, still $2. So this is the way I can use the knowledge of the, subtracting the number zero in my word problems. So over here, it's very important to understand this particular sentence that you did not buy any snacks. That means I did not spend any money over here. Let us take another example, and that means another word problem over here. So this problem says that the school cafeteria makes 61 lunches for a field trip. So the important part over here is to know this. If everyone on the trip gets one lunch and 10 of the lunches go to parents and staff, how many students are on the trip? Now, this is a very interesting word problem, and let's see how can we solve it. So the school cafeteria makes 61 lunches altogether. So this is the total number of lunches which they make. If everyone on the trip gets one lunch and 10 of the lunches go to the parent and staff, so I need to go ahead and divide the 61 into kind of two parts. So there is parents and staff for which 10 lunches are been sent. And the rest of the lunches are kept for the students. Now over here, what would I do is I will have to take away the 10 lunches which went for the parents and staff from the total number of lunches. So technically, I will go ahead and subtract a 10 from 61. Then I will get the number of lunches which went to the students, assuming each student is having only one lunch. So if I take away this 110 from number 6, as I told you, there will be no change in the ones column. So what will I get the answer as? 51. So I can clearly say that provided there was only one lunch given to each student, there were 51 students on the trip. Now, I hope this concept is very clear to you. And now we are going to be learning a very interesting topic, which it says adding doubles. In our previous classes, we have discussed what is the meaning of double. And now let's just reiterate that. Double means that when you are adding the same number again. Like for example, if I have a number 5, I'm going to add a 5 to it to make it a 10. So I can say that the double of this 5 would be another 5. Similarly, if I take the number 4 and if I want to add the double to it, so I will add the 4 and make it a 8. So this is the concept of adding the doubles. You just need to add the same number again. Considering this concept, let us see a very interesting puzzle kind of a thing over here. Now, if you see, I have certain numbers listed on the left side of the column, and we have to match it to the right side of the column. So over here, I can clearly see that there are two numbers added in each section, and both the numbers are the same. So here, I'm adding the doubles. So 1 plus 1 would be a 2. So I'll match this particular section with a 2. Further, I see that 2 plus 2 is a 4. So I'll match it over here. 3 plus 3 makes a 6. So I'll match it over here. Let's take another color. So 4 plus 4 makes it a 8. So I'll match it to this column. And lastly, 5 plus 5 makes it a 10. So I would match it to this column. So over here, you saw that we used the concept of adding the doubles and solved this puzzle. I hope these concepts are clear to you. We will be seeing some more examples in our future classes. Thank you so much. Bye.